Hello and welcome back to another episode of the ESET and Ingram Micro Vlog Series. I'm Mike Eterno, Director of Channel Sales here at ESET. In our last episode, we talked about an unfortunately common but increasingly widespread threat type known as ransomware and how ESET's technology can protect businesses from falling victim to this insidious threat. This is episode 3. And today we'll be discussing yet another very common threat facing businesses today. It's called phishing. I'm delighted to be joined by Aubrey Berish, one of ESET's many outstanding instructional designers, to talk about the subject and the ways ESET can help protect against phishing attacks. Aubrey, the floor is all yours.
Awesome. Thanks, Mike. So as Mike said, I'm Aubrey Berish, and I am an instructional designer here at ESET. So there's countless different phishing attacks, but here at ESET, we see the same patterns and techniques again and again and again. It's common for phishing attacks to impersonate tempting business opportunities, emails from your IT department, or even threats about debts. And those same attacks show up in our inboxes too, so even a security company like us isn't immune from this. The wording changes, but we see the same basic phishing scams so often because they work on uneducated users. And that's what makes good cybersecurity training so key. Once users can spot the signs of these scams, they stay cool-headed and they don't take the bait. So understanding those red flags is really a first line of defense because an organization's users aren't always within your IT's bubble. You know, they're getting phished on personal devices too. So catching phishing before it makes it to users, though, is even better. So to that end, ESET has had dedicated anti-phishing functionality built into our products for endpoints, for mobile devices, and our server products for years. And now, as companies are starting to transition onto cloud platforms, such as Office 365, we've recently launched tools like ESET Cloud Office Security, which are purpose-built and designed for this new environment. Attackers will also often exploit a crisis, and there's been a big uptick in COVID-19-related phishing attacks. Here at ESET, we've seen things like fake video conference requests. We've seen attackers posing as the government or other organizations that would offer benefits. And atop all of this, many users are also transitioning to a work-from-home model, and because of that, personal and work-related electronics are often on the same network, which means keeping those devices secure is a huge priority. So, Mike, now that we've touched on some of the things when it comes to phishing, what will we be talking about in the final episode of the vlog series?
Well, thanks, Aubrey. I appreciate that. That was a great overview of phishing as an increased threat vector in the current work-from-home environment. In our next and unfortunately last episode of this four-part series, we'll take a deep dive into the security needs of the remote workforce and how businesses can protect their data and employee devices while spread out across countries and even continents. Thanks for watching episode 3, and remember, make sure to like this video and subscribe to this channel for more great content. Thanks again for joining us. We'll see you back here next time for episode 4.